Dual booting Ubuntu and Windows is not that complicated, and I have shown it to you in the past tutorials. And yet here I'm talking about it again. Why? Because the scenario is slightly different and several people have asked question about this particular scenario. Here's the scenario. You have a new computer that comes with SSD with limited disk space like 120 GB and an additional hard disk with 500 GB or 1 TB of disk space. So how do you dual boot on a system with two disks? You have three options. You can install Linux completely on SSD. This way you will get full advantage of SSD speed, but then you will only have a limited disk space for both the operating systems. Second option is to install Linux completely on the hard disk. You will have plenty of disk space, but Linux will boot slower and you won't get the SSD advantage. The third option is a compromise between SSD and the hard disk. Here you install the root partition of Linux on the SSD and put the home directory on the hard disk. This way your system boots faster into Linux and you have plenty of disk space for your personal documents and downloads. So what do you need for this tutorial? You need a computer that comes pre-installed with Windows 10 and has both an SSD and a hard disk. You should have a USB key with at least 4 GB in size and no important data on it because it will be formatted. You should have a good internet connection for downloading the ISO image and downloading the live USB creating tool. Optionally, you should have an external USB disk where you can copy your important data from Windows 10. Optionally again, you may also have a Windows recovery disk so that if you encounter any major boot issues, you should be able to fix it with that. So let's proceed with the step one, which is to make a backup of your data. Making a backup simply means plug in the external USB disk and copy your important files on it. This is the simplest way of doing it, and having a backup is always a good idea because you will be playing with the disk partition, so you can never be too careful. Step 2, making disk partition for Linux installation. In the Windows menu, search for disk and go to create and format hard disk option. You will see both SSD and the hard disk here. What you have to do here is to shrink both SSD and the hard disk one by one and make some free space that will be utilized later for installing Ubuntu. Right click on the SSD and choose shrink volume option. It will give you the largest possible disk partition you can make here. Don't use it all of it. Leave some extra space for Windows. So in my case, I have given it 30 GB, which is a decent disk space for the root partition. Anything between 20 and 40 GB is a fair choice here. Now repeat the process with the hard disk as well. I made around 200 GB of free space for Linux. You're free to decide how much space you want to allocate to Ubuntu. Here is the final disk scenario for my system. Around 30 GB free space on SSD and around 200 GB of free space on the hard disk. I think that's a good amount of space for Linux. The next step is to download Ubuntu. Go to Ubuntu's website and download the ISO file. If you need torrents, you can also find it under the alternative downloads. This ISO is a single file of around 2.7 GB of size. The next thing you'll need is to download a tool for creating live USB. You can use a tool like Rufus or Etcher. I'm going to use Rufus in this tutorial. So download Rufus and run it from the exe file. Now plug in your USB. Make sure it doesn't have any important data on it. Now run the Rufus tool. It automatically identifies the plugged in USB, but double check it just to make sure. Now browse to the location of the downloaded Ubuntu ISO image and ensure that the partitioning scheme is GPT and target is UEFI. Hit the start button and wait for the process to complete. Once you have the live Ubuntu USB ready, the next step is to boot from it. To do that, in the Windows menu, search for UEFI and click on Change Advanced Startup Options. Under the Advanced Startup option, click on Restart Now button. On the next screen, click on User Device. You can recognize the USB disk from its name and size. Now your system will be turned off and it will reboot into the disk you chose, which should be the live USB disk. You should see a screen like this. You can opt for install Ubuntu or you can try Ubuntu without installing. Both will help you install Linux. So the next step is the actual Linux installation. Now that you have booted from the live USB, you can start the installation procedure. The first few steps are really simple. You choose the language and then the keyboard layout. On the next screen, choose normal installation. No need to download updates or install third-party software just yet. You may do it after installation completes. After some time, you will see the installation type screen. Here, opt for something else option. On the next screen, you should see the free space you had created earlier. Select the free space created on SSD, you can guess it by the size if nothing else, and click on the plus sign to use this free space. By default, it will take the entire free space, which is a good thing. Keep the partition type primary. What you need to change is the file system type to ext4 and the mount point to root. This forward slash means root in Linux. Now, select the other free space on the HDD and click the plus sign. This time, choose home as the mount point. Partition remains primary and file type will remain ext4. I have not created a separate swap partition because a newer Ubuntu version, you get a swap file directly under the root partition. You don't need to worry about device for bootloader installation because Ubuntu is intelligent enough to identify the ESP partition which is already on your system. You can move between HDD or SSD for the device bootloader installation, but it should not matter in my opinion. This is the final partitioning scheme for my system, and as you can see, I have a mount point for root and a mount point for home. So everything looks good. Now, hit the install now button. Things are pretty straightforward from here. Select a time zone, enter username, computer name, host name, and of course, an easy to remember password. Now wait for like 6-10 minutes, something like that, and wait for the Ubuntu installation to complete. When the installation finishes, you will be asked to restart your system. Restart it and then you will be asked to remove the USB disk as well. Remove the disk and press enter. Your system will reboot and if everything has gone right, you should see this black or purple grub screen where you will have the option to boot into both Linux and Windows, and you can choose which one to boot into from this screen. That's it. You can now enjoy both Windows and Linux on the same system with SSD and hard disk, HDD. Nice, isn't it? I hope this tutorial was helpful to you. If you are still facing some issues or if you have any questions, you can always leave a comment and I'll try to help you out. And please do not forget to subscribe for more Linux related content on atsvos.com YouTube channel. See you in the next video. Bye bye.